Hello everyone, today we will discuss about our new topic, that is channels in marketing of milk. The dairy farmer has four channels by which he may market his farm milk. The first one is direct to the consumers. The dairy produce milk and milk products can be marketed directly to the consumers. Whatever the milk and milk products are there, they are directly marketed to the consumers. Then direct marketing of milk enables the dairy farmer to receive the highest returns from his products. This direct marketing is very profitable because all the highest returns from this produce will get or receive to the dairy producer or the farmer. If it produces quality milk and make it in business like manner, he will profit more by selling the milk himself than through any agency or organization. If the milk is of good quality, then it will give the more profit. If we sell the milk directly to the consumers than through any agency or organization. The next one channel is the through cooperatives. The dairy products can also be marketed on cooperative basis. A cooperative marketing organization may be formed by the local producers for marketing their products on cooperative lines. A cooperative organization, properly and efficiently managed, enables its members to get good returns for their dairy products. The next is through privately owned organization. The dairy farmers who would not market their own products or avail themselves to cooperative marketing have third venue through which he may market his products, that is the privately owned agencies. The farmers who don't market their own milk or milk products directly to the consumers, or they have not joined any cooperative marketing agency, then the third option for them is the privately owned agencies. Very often the privately owned marketing agency is managed so efficiently, and it is very efficiently managed and has so many other factors in its favor that the farmers may receive a satisfactory price by selling through this venue and eliminate any further concern about his product. So at present, a large quantity of dairy products are so marketed in urban industrial areas of the country. Then through government milk supply schemes. The recent emergence of government milk supply schemes has opened yet another channel for the farmer through which he may market his milk. Milk is purchased from the producers by these schemes at fairly remunerative price. Over and above premium is paid for high quality of milk and higher butter fat content of the milk to provide the incentive to the farmers. As per the quality and as per the fat content of the milk, the price will be given to the farmers. The marketing of milk. Marketing of milk is done by planning production so that large quantities of milk can be marketed during the season of high price. During the season of high prices, the planning of production should be done so that large quantities of milk can be marketed. The next one is the selecting the form in which to sell the products that will yield the largest net returns. The form in which you want to sell the milk, that should be selected to get the largest net returns. Whether you are selling in the products form or whether you are selling the liquid milks, that you should be selected. So improving the quality of the products to be sold. Whatever the products we are selling to the consumers, we have to improve the quality of that product. Milk can be sold individually through cooperative society or through government milk schemes. So we can sell the milk individually through the cooperative society or through the government schemes. these are the three channels we can sell the milk. For the private agency also you can, through private agency also you can sell the milks. Means these are the four channels for selling the milk. Then here you can see the producer, unorganized and organized sector. In unorganized sector, milk vendor, from milk vendor to the wholesalers, from wholesalers to the retailers. In organized sector, government, village cooperatives, private, from this to the district level, milk producers, cooperative union, from district level to the village level, milk producers, cooperative society, and from this organized and unorganized sector, from these two, the milk goes to the retailer. Then we will discuss what is meant by vendor. Vendor is a person or company offering something for sale, especially a trader in the street. That we call as the vendor. And what is meant by retailer? Retailer is a person or business that sells goods to the public in relatively small quantities for use or consumption rather than the resale. So the retailer can't resell the quantities for whatever the goods he purchased. That we call as the retailer. The wholesaler is a person or company that sells goods in large quantities at low price, typically to the retailers. So these are the meaning of vendor, wholesaler and retailer.